we have an incredibly powerful tool to fight climate change. It's called the Zero Carbon Grid, and it enables everything. The Zero Carbon Grid uses onshore wind, offshore wind, solar, geothermal, biomass, nuclear, hydro, combines them, optimizes them so that we don't have pollution from the electric grid. When you start to put these technologies together, you get a zero carbon grid. And then we use that zero carbon electricity to run our vehicles. We electrify our vehicles, we electrify our homes, we electrify our industry. This is the fastest, most comprehensive way of driving carbon out of the system. And that's as close to magic as you can get in trying to reduce climate change. In the early days of renewable energy, you might have a handful of wind turbines, let's say in one county in Minnesota. And the wind might stop, and then you've got a problem. But now let's spread wind turbines across much larger areas of Minnesota. It's going to be windy somewhere. It's going to be windy in many parts. Your problem gets much smaller. And it's been proved again and again that if you have some geographic spread for your sources, they smooth each other out just amazingly. So now spread the resources across the country with onshore wind, with offshore wind, with solar, and hook them together. And you really begin to solve the problem just by doing that. So think about eastern Wyoming, which is really the single windiest spot in America, and Las Vegas, Nevada, which is incredibly hot and sucks up a lot of energy to run all those casinos and everything else. Hook those two together with a big copper cable, and they completely help each other out. The incredible winds in Wyoming can help during the hottest days of summer down in Las Vegas. And when Wyoming needs extra electricity because it's so cold, those solar panels in Las Vegas can help do the trick. It's already projected that California is going to have excessive zero carbon energy in the middle of summer for about 6 hours a day in the not too distant future. I think that's what you would call a high quality problem. Too much, incredibly cheap, carbon-free electricity. I'm pretty sure we're going to find a good use for that, especially if the grid's all put together. So what are the obstacles to this zero carbon grid? The people that have the old power plants will fight as hard as they can to protect them. Anyone who owns an old coal-fired power plant or a natural gas generator is going to try to rig the system as they're doing already to keep their power plants running and to keep renewable energy offline. Not long ago, the coal and nuclear industries tried to create a new regulation that says any power supply that has 90 days of fuel in a big pile next to it gets to be dispatched preferentially before everybody else. Well, that's an insane idea. You can't have 90 days worth of sunshine piled up next to your solar panels or 90 days of wind. Why did they have that 90 days number? No reason at all except to give their technology an advantage over the new ones. So there's a lot of monkey business going on in the power markets in America, trying to protect the old power sources rather than accelerate the new ones. So transforming our electric system is the great enabler. First of all, it's easier to decarbonize the electric grid than any of the other sectors. And secondly, when you create a zero carbon grid, it opens up vast opportunities in transportation, buildings, and industry. So here's the big point. We can go to 60, 70, 80% renewables without headaches if we manage the grid properly. That's pretty great.